Hello there, good morning. Osamede Okhomina is joining us today from ADM because we're going to talk about your full year results for 2021. They're just off the press just now. So I guess it makes sense for us to get you to give us an update on the operational performance to begin with for 2021.
2021, thank you, Kate. 2021 was a good year. As you know, we got a new chief engineer, Dr. Pierce, who's from ExxonMobil, who was tasked with managing our main project, which is the Aje project. Oliver Andrew, who you all know was Chief Investment Officer of African Finance Corporation, joined the board of the chairman. He has brought to us a considerable network of new financiers and investors for the company going forward. We also closed the Barracuda deal, which added a new asset to our portfolio, one of which we are currently contemplating developing as well. So it was a very good year as well. We did a lot of transactions, which some of them didn't close because we're caught out by the movement in the oil prices. So sellers, were asking, making a reasonable demand. But the whole process of trying to fund these acquisitions taught us a couple of valuable lessons and allowed us to understand better how to structure deals. So it was a very productive year in terms of the corporate, and we built out a pretty, what we consider a pretty good and effective management team. So it was a good year.
All right, good year, you say. Right, let's maybe dig into the financials here, because I think you're investing. Yes. What a clear idea as to how the balance sheet is shaping up. Let's maybe talk about some of these numbers. So revenue increased by 125% to £1.8 million. In 2020, £0.8 million. And we're going to talk about the oil price, of course, as well, that's reflecting. And loss after tax decreased 64% to £2.5 million from £6.9 million in 2020. Maybe just give your overview, if you would, of the financials. Are they in good nick?
And then good news, I mean, revenue increase was due primarily to oil price increase. And also, last year was the first year where we consolidated our interest in the Aje Field when we purchased the stake. So a better overview of what the company really looks like. We continue investment support for the company, so we managed to raise significant amounts of equity. So all in all, the balance sheet looks good. The company looks stronger. So we're very happy with the financial performance we had before.
All right, so let's move on and talk about the expected conclusion of your PetroNor Aponoro deal. What does this mean for your prospects in the Aje?
I mean, part of the delay in achieving FID on the Aje project was, a new partner coming in. So the PetroNor Aponoro transaction was only announced completion in January. There are a couple of, regulatory formalities that they have to conclude, which they will do sometime, I think, this month, next month. But that has not stopped all the background planning on the project. So as you can imagine, with Dr. Pierce, we've done a lot of work in coming up with the development concepts, searching out the market, looking for new gas off-takers. And PetroNor themselves, who, whilst they were not on the license, done a lot of work as well. So we had a major technical session with them in February, where they presented to us their plans for the asset. And the beauty was that all our, our subsurface work was more or less integrated, and we accept each other's conclusions and points of view. So in terms of where we are, in terms of the project, we are totally aligned. So now we're just going into the final development planning phase. So it's all very good on the asset front,
All right. And any sort of upcoming developments or news that investors can kind of look forward to?
Yes, plenty. We're going towards FID on the Aje project. We're still doing our final determination on whether we're going to drill the Barracuda field. We are looking at changing out the FPSO on the project to bring a bigger one that can do better gas handling. So there's a lot of news flow. The gas markets have exploded. As Aje is primarily a gas field. So we've seen a lot of demand from European buyers. We're creating now, working together with a group of financiers to create a midstream business that would offtake the gas. So it promises to be a very active and busy months ahead. We are also looking into the renewable space. We're looking to expand our business into that section as well. So the market should get a lot of updates in the coming months, and we are just as busy as ever.
As busy as ever, and active and busy months ahead, as you say also. So it sounds like we'll be talking a lot more. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you very much, Katie. Have a lovely day. Bye-bye.